Children, it's your English video and this is the day third video of this week, right? In the previous two classes of this week, we all dealt with the exercise of chapter number 7, that was rabbit's turnip, and we completed with all the exercise of the chapter. So now we will be moving ahead towards a new chapter, that is chapter number 8. But before starting the video, I would like to request you all that please open your book while watching the video and watch the video till the end. Keep a pencil in your hand so that you can underline the words. Okay? Let's move towards the chapter. That is chapter number 8. The name of the chapter is The Song of the Train. I would like to give you all a hint about what the chapter is. The chapter The Song of the Train is about a girl named Minnie. She is just 6 years old and she is traveling by train for the very first time ever in her life. And she is traveling on a train to visit her grandparents. Okay, so we will be seeing Minnie's first experience in the story. Whatever she saw, who are the new people she met, and her experience. So let's move ahead to the chapter. You have to take out page number 67 for that. Let's start. Minnie, her mother and her father are going to visit Minnie's grandparents. Please underline the word grandparents. They are traveling by train. Underline the word traveling. They are traveling by train. Minnie is 6 years old, but she has never traveled on a train before. So everything is new to her. Now, what do you all understand by grandparents? Our parents' parents are known as our grandparents, right? So Minnie, her mother and her father were going to visit Minnie's grandparents, and they were going to visit Minnie's grandparents by train. They were traveling by train. And how many years old Minnie is? Minnie is 6 years old, right? And she has never ever traveled before in a train. So everything there is new to her. The platforms, the coolies, the ticket examiners, the porters, the shopkeepers, the lights, the birds, everything present in the train is new to her. So we will be seeing her experience, that how she felt in her first ever train journey. The train whistled twice, hoot hoot. There was a slight jerk and the train started. First it moved slowly, chook chook chook. Okay, so the word which you have to underline here is whistled. It is whistled. The sound of the train, okay, that is known as whistling. What is it known as? Whistling, which means that the train whistled twice. What is the meaning of twice? Two times. What sound did the train took out? It took out hoot hoot. And there was a slight jerk, okay. What is the meaning of slight jerk? You have to underline slight jerk, children. Slight jerk means a sudden movement. What is the meaning of slight jerk? Slight jerk means a sudden movement. Okay, there was a sudden movement and then the train started. And in the beginning, the train moved slowly. You all can see chook, chook, chook. What is this chook, chook, chook here, children? It is the sound of the train. Soon it went faster and faster. Chuck, chuck, chuck. Chuck, chuck, Chuck. Okay? So, what is hoot hoot? It's the whistling sound of the train. What is chook chook chook? It is the slow, it is the time, it is the sound of the train when it moves slowly. And as the train, the speed of the train becomes faster, the sound changes to chuck chuck chuck. Right? Now let's move to next. What happens next? Minnie looked out of the window. It was a sunny afternoon. Yes, so Minnie was sitting on her seat and she was looking out of the window. And it was a sunny afternoon, which means that the sun was at the head. Right? Now, a man was working in the fields. A woman was drawing water from a well. Some children were playing. They looked at the train and waved. Even the trees waved their branches. Okay, now children, this is the scenery which Minnie is seeing from the train. Okay, Minnie is sitting inside the train and she is looking these sceneries which is happening outside the train. Okay, so what did she saw? What is she seeing? What is she seeing there? She is seeing a man who is working in the field. She is seeing a woman who is drawing water from a well. She is seeing some children playing. Right? She is seeing some children playing. And she is even seeing that the children who are playing there, they are waving at her. Please underline the word waved. Underline the word waved. Waved means saying hi or bye. You all show like this, no? This is waving. Okay. So the children which were outside, they were playing. And when they saw the train, they waved. You all also wave, no? When aeroplane flies by, when aeroplane goes in the sky, and you all see there and you all say hi or bye. You all do this? You all wave your hands at it? Just in the same way, those children were waving their hands by looking at the train. Even the trees waved their branches and the trees were moving. The trees were moving. Minnie thought that the trees were moving. Okay, the trees are just having a movement like this, and Minnie is thinking that the tree, the branches of the trees are waving at her. Okay, now the trees are running so fast, said Minnie. What did Minnie said? When Minnie saw that as the children, you all might have seen that when you are in a car, okay, when you are moving on a car, in a car, or when you are moving in a train also, you all might have seen that the scenery, the view which is there, it seems like they are running, but it isn't. Actually, we are moving, right? So in the same way, as Minnie was a very little girl, okay, she thought that trees are running, and Minnie said this to her mother. No, Minnie, laughed her mother. So her mother laughed at Minnie and said, no, Minnie, you are wrong. The trees are not running. The train is moving and we are moving with it. Children, now we are in page number 68 of the book. So please turn to the page, okay? So what did Minnie's mother said to Minnie? Minnie's mother laughed at Minnie and she said that the trees are not running. The train is moving and we are moving with the train. Okay, let's see next. Your tickets, please, said a man in uniform. Please underline the word uniform, children. What do you all understand by the word uniform? Uniform is a particular dress given to a person who belongs to a particular field. Right? So the person, a man in uniform, was there and he asked to show them their tickets. Who is this man? Whispered Minnie. And Minnie is whispering now. Please underline the word whispered. What is whispering? See, if I'm saying like this, who is this man? Okay, this is whispering. I don't know you all heard it or not, but this is whispering. Okay, You're not taking out a sound from the mouth, but your lips are moving and the sound is very low. So Minnie is whispering, thinking about the man. That who is this man in the uniform? He is the ticket examiner, replied Minnie's father. Please underline the word examiner. So what did Minnie's father reply at this? Minnie's father said to Minnie that he is the ticket examiner, the one who checks the tickets. He wants to see our tickets, and Minnie's father is telling to Minnie that this ticket examiner wants to see our tickets. Minnie's mother gave their tickets to the man. He looked at them. And now what did Minnie's mother do? Minnie's mother took out their tickets and she gave it to the man in uniform. And the man in return looked back at them. Thank you, he said, and gave the tickets back to her. And after seeing the tickets, the ticket examiner, which was the man in uniform, gave the ticket back to Minnie's mother. Now, Minnie looked out of the window. It was so beautiful outside. So now when the ticket examiner went back, okay, Minnie started looking out of the window just in the same way she was doing it earlier. Okay, and as she was looking outside, she was seeing that it was very beautiful outside. Okay, the sun was setting. It looked like a giant orange. Herds of cattle were walking across the fields. Flocks of birds were flying in the sky. Then the sun went behind a hill. Soon it began to grow dark. So now the sun was setting, which means that it was the time of sunset. What is the meaning of the sun was setting? That it was the time of sunset. And the sun was looking like a giant orange. It was in yellow color. As the sun was setting down, it was in yellow color and it was seeming like it's a giant orange present there. Underline the word giant. Herds of cattle were walking across the field. Underline herds and cattle. Children, herds means group. The meaning of the word herds means group, and the meaning of the word cattle is farm animals, which means that the group of farm animals were walking across the fields. And this is the scenery which is seen by Minnie from the train, and the scenery is happening outside the train in a field. Okay, so Minnie is seeing the herds of cattle that were walking across the field. Flocks of birds were flying in the sky. Please underline the word flocks. Flocks are, you can say flock is a collective noun which is used for birds. Okay? So flocks of birds were flying in the sky. Then the sun went behind a hill. And as it is mentioned, know that the sun was setting. So yes, sunset's time was there. So the sun went behind a hill. Soon it began to grow dark, and now it was dark everywhere. Okay, outside the train, of course. Lights came on in the train. Dinner coupons, said a man. Minnie's mother bought 3 coupons. Please underline the word coupons, children. Now, as outside, okay, dinner, as outside darkness was there, the sunset already happened, so it was night now, right? And as it was night, you all might have seen trains that the lights of the trains are on in the night time, right? So the lights came on in the train and a man came and said, dinner coupons. Now, what is the meaning of the word coupons? Children, coupons are the words, sorry, coupons, you can say coupon is a piece of paper. Okay, coupon is a piece of paper which is used to buy something. Okay, we use a piece of paper in order to buy something. Those pieces of papers are known as coupons. So the man said, dinner coupons and Minnie's mother bought 3 coupons. Now, children, why did Minnie's mother bought 3 coupons? Yes, why Minnie's mother brought 3 coupons? She brought it because there were 3 people in the family, Minnie, her father and her mother, right? That's why she bought 3 coupons, okay? The train was slowing down, chook, 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 right?
Students, after the train was slowing down, what will happen? We will see in the next class. Students, now all of you take down your third term 5-subject note and turn the new page and write today's day 16-3-21, lesson 8, the song of the train. The song of the train. New words. First from letter, new words. Whistled. Whistled. W-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. And the second one, twice. Twice. T-W-I-C-E. Twice. T-W-I-C-E. Twice. Third one, waved. Waved. W-A-V-E-D, waved. W-A-V-E-D, waved. Examiner. So, examiner. Waved na enadhu alai. Waved na enadhu alai. An examiner. Examiner na test check pandravanga. Check pandravanga. Test kar kottam illa vera. Endha reason arundhal check pandravanga. Examiner. So, E-X-A-M-I-N-E-R, examiner. E-X-A-M-I-N-E-R, examiner. The next, giant. Giant. So, G-I-A-N-T, giant. J-A-N-T, ant, giant. So, giant means, peris. Perisa or the giant. Big kumelaima sort of the giant. Platform. 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 So, platform na? So, space irukkradhala, adhala nama nadandhu pokkura edam. Innu railway station la nama nadandhukkura edam solittu irukku, adhu platform. So, engniyadhu nama road pakkathula side la irukkakuriyadhu, andhu nadakkura edathukku vandhu platform. Then, porters. Porters. P-O-R-T-E-R, yes, porters. Porters na yaarna, ivunga tha porters. The railway station la, the dress, namlode things alaan thu eat porudhukko, urthanga red color dress porter pangala, avunga tha porters. P-O-R-T-E-R, yes, porters. And next one, birds. B-E-R-T-H-S, birds. B-E-R-T-H-S, and train la ulla berth padukra edathukku dhaan peru birds. So inge indha ponnu paduthirukka paaru indha edam dhaan idhu dhaan birds. Blanket. B L A N K E T, blanket. B L A N K E T, blanket. Blanket na nama moodra bed sheet, nama edha moodikiromo adhu peru dhaan blanket. Paduthadhukku appuram moodikira bed sheet peru blanket. Asleep, A-S-L-E-E-P, sleep. Asleep, sleep, rendume onu da, thoongrada. A-S-L-E-E-P, asleep. And next one, second room letter, synonyms. A slight jerk, a sudden, quick, short movement. A sudden, quick, short movement. And the second one, whisper. Whisper speak in a low voice. Meduva munumunukrada. Sometimes ida class nadandirukumbod yaradu meduva munumunuthu pakkathil irukkar friends to pesitirupingala adhu dhaan enadhu whisper. Speak in a low voice. Giant. So giant na already I told bigger than the bigger. So adhavadhu bigger vida konja perusu. That is giant na romba perusa irukkar romba periya oru huge. Flock, group. ஃப்ளாக் குரூப். ஸோ ஃப்ளாக்ங்கிறது ஒரு பேர்ட்ஸுக்குரிய குரூப்பை சொல்கிறது, அதுக்கு பேர். அதேமாரி ஹர்டுங்கிறது அனிமல்ஸ்க்குரிய குரூப்பை சொல்கிறது. ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி ஒவ்வொரு குரூப்புக்கும் நம்ம கொத்து கொத்தா கூட்டம் கூட்டமான்னு சொல்லி தமிழில் படிப்போம்ல, அதே மாதிரி தான் இங்கிலீஷில் குரூப்புங்கிறது தான் அதுக்கு டிஃப்ரெண்ட்டான வேர்ட்ஸ் இருக்குது. ஃப்ளாக் குரூப், ஃப்ளாக் குரூப். அண்ட் ஃபிஃப்த் ஒன் போச்சர்ஸ். ஸோ போச்சர்ஸ் பீப்புள் ஹூ கேரி பீப்புள்ஸ் பேக்ஸ் அட் ரயில்வே ஸ்டேஷன். ஸோ ரயில்வே ஸ்டேஷனில் ரெட் கலர் ட்ரெஸ் போட்டு இருக்கிறவங்க தான் யார்? போச்சர்ஸ். அந்த பேக் எல்லாம் தூக்குறதுக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்ணதுக்கு ஒருத்தவங்க இருப்பாங்க, அவங்க தான் போச்சர்ஸ். பீப்புள் ஹூ கேரி பீப்புள்ஸ் பேக் அட் ரயில்வே ஸ்டேஷன். ஸ்பீட், ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஸ்பெட் அண்ட் ஸ்பெட் இன் த ஃபாஸ்ட் அண்ட் சப் ஸ்பீட். ஸோ ஸ்பெட் மூவ்ட் வித் த கிரேட் ஸ்பீட், மூவ்ட் வித் த கிரேட் ஸ்பீடா. ஸோ ஸ்பீட் வந்து ஸ்பெட்ங்கிறது ரொம்ப ஸ்பீடாக போகக்கூடியது, தட் இஸ் ஃபாஸ்ட் அண்ட் சப் ஸ்பீட். அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் யர் டுடேஸ் அசைன்மெண்ட் டு ஒர்க். ஃபஸ்ட் ரோம் லெட்டர் அண்ட் செகண்ட் ரோம் லெட்டர் ஒன்லி. ஓகே ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், அண்ட் ரைட் வெரி நீட்லி. And you should write first room letter 1 to 10 new words. And the second room letter 1 to 6 synonyms. Study and write thoroughly. Thank you for watching.